Hi, today I'm going to teach you how to use Vocaroo to create QR codes that you can use with your students that have a need for audio recording or oral administration. So, what is a QR code? If you don't know what a QR code is, it is a quick response code that when scanned takes the user directly to websites, text, audio, videos, or pictures. QR codes are free and easy to create. What will you learn today? You're going to learn two things. The first thing is how to create an audio QR code using Vocaroo, and the second is how to teach your students to access your Vocaroo created QR codes with their iDevice. What will you need? Simply, you will need a computer with internet access and a microphone. Speaking of microphones, you will need some sort of external USB microphone to make your recordings. Some laptops do have an internal microphone for recording, but you should test it out to ensure the audio is of sufficient quality. Go to www.vocaroo.com. You will see this screen. This is where you will record your audio. I will warn you that sometimes when you click to record for the first time, you will get a pop-up message asking you if you want to allow Vocaroo to access your microphone. Click yes. You are now ready to record. It is very important to note that once you click to record, there is no countdown or pause. Recording begins immediately and continues until you click the click stop button. You are now finished with your recording and will click the click stop button that is flashing in the middle of your screen. After you have stopped recording, this is the screen you will see next. I suggest that you click listen to preview your recording. Sometimes you need to adjust the volume of your mic or placement of the mic to ensure a better quality recording. If you did not like your recording, simply click retry to begin again. After you have previewed your recording, you are ready to save your recording by clicking click here to save. After clicking Save Your Recording, you will see this screen. It gives you many different options, but for our purposes today, you will click QR code. A new tab will open in your browser with the QR representation of your audio recording. Be sure to not close out the original Vocaroo tab at this point. You will be clicking that tab to continue making QR codes and recordings. To copy your QR code, right-click the image, then scroll down to Copy Image. At this point, I have the test or document I am recording ready on my computer minimized. You can close out each tab that has a QR code on it as you successfully paste each code into your Word document. Here I have a section of the document I am recording open. You will need to click to insert a text box. You can see my text box image here. You will want to size your text box fairly close to your desired size now by using the corner arrows of your text box. Put your cursor in the text box and right-click, then paste. Your QR code will appear in the text box. You can move the text box around if needed at this point by clicking on the outer border of the text box. You cannot resize at this point without affecting the QR code size. This is why it's important to have your text box close to your desired size before you paste your QR code. After you have inserted all of your QR codes, save your document, then print for student use. What will your students need? They will need an iDevice with a camera, a set of earphones, and a scanner app loaded on their device. Below, you can see the free scanner app that my students have had the most consistent luck with. There are other free scanner apps, so feel free to check them out to find out what works best for you and your students. Now let's get started having your students using your QR codes. Have your students hold their iDevice over the QR code to be scanned and move it until they see a green border on their screen around the QR code. The next screen that will appear will be the Vocaroo screen. This screen will take a little teaching and training by you for your students, as the screen is a bit cluttered. The only thing they need to touch or push is the black triangle in the middle of the screen. This is the play button for the recording. The student can pause the recording by clicking the pause lines and can resume listening by clicking the black triangle. The student can listen to the recording as many times as needed. To scan the next question, the student will click the Scan button in the top left of their screen. This process of scanning and listening begins again. The student repeats this process until they have heard each of the questions. Something that's really important to note is that Vocaroo only stores your audio recordings for a few months. So if you desire to create a more permanent QR code recording, there are many other options to use. I personally use Vocaroo for tests, as my general ed teachers change their test every year, so I don't need a permanent QR code solution. If you have questions or need help, please don't hesitate to contact me via email or phone. Here are a few helpful links that might help you learn more about QR codes. The first link is a list of scanning apps for you to explore. The second link is from the Three Tech Ninjas. Now, the link that I've given you is just their QR code portion of their website, but I encourage you to check out their entire site because there's lots of great tech stuff beyond just QR codes on their site. The third link is to Janet Corder and Joan Gore's QR Codes Live Binder. Now, if you're not familiar with Live Binders, it's a repository for all different links within one space. Think of it as a digital notebook with dividers. These ladies have some amazing QR resources and they're ready to go, ready to print out. Not necessarily to use for oral administration, but there's some great activities that you should check out.